she will address the topic of, okay, in English, the contribution of learning orientations to school success and well-being, results of studies conducted with students and teachers.
Thank you. Good morning to everyone. My name is Giulia Vittori and I am a researcher in educational and developmental psychology at the University of Florence. And thank you very much for this opportunity to share our research works on this research topic focused on learning orientations. So this is going to be a talk organized in four parts. In the first part, I will focus on the relevance of focusing on students and teachers' learning orientations. And then I will try to define and explain this complex and articulated construct of learning orientation that is a multidimensional construct. Then I will go through our principal research results, those based on preservice teachers and those based on secondary school students. And also I will describe you the relation we have found between students' learning orientations and their school outcomes. And finally, I will try to discuss some new research lines derived from our research studies. So, national and international records inform about a significant part of students that are underachieving in several disciplines and subject areas. And several studies and literature have tried to explain school success and failure based on different constructs, for example, attributional theory, motivation, self-regulation. A part of studies focus on learning orientations, and there is evidence that this construct of learning orientation may contribute in explaining school outcomes and school performance, because student conceptions of learning influence their learning strategies and studying approach, and so they influence also motivation and school performances. Studies derived from a variable-oriented approach allowed us to identify specific conception of learnings, deep and surface conception of learning that relate differently with school performances. And moving forward this research line and assuming a person-oriented approach allowed us to identify specific configuration of cognitive, regulative, affective, and social dimensions of learning at the level of students' mental representation. So we try to assume this kind of perspective to identify different kind of profiles of learning orientation among teachers and students. And I will try to discuss and present some main results in this research line. And I will also discuss a bit about the relation we found between learning orientation and long-term effects on university pathways and dropouts. And to do this, I will firstly refer to the construct we assume, that is a quite articulated and a multidimensional construct. So when we were thinking to learning orientations, we refer to different types of dimensions. We refer to the cognitive and self-regulation aspects. For example, some students think at learning as a primarily a memorization process, memorization activity. We also need to think to emotions and motivation. For example, we find that some students have higher level on the conception of learning as personal, as an opportunity for personal growth and change. And we also need to think to the individual and social dimensions of learning. So we have a part of students that think to learning as an individual practice process. And on the other side, we have other students that think that learning as a collaborative and a social practice. At the same time, we have to take in mind that other factors, mainly related to the environment and culture, family values, or also teachers' conception of learning may influence students' learning orientation. These indirectly have an impact on school performances and outcomes. So I'm going to already completed the work and present you some main results on this research line, because we think it is important to assume the point of view of students and teachers about learning, what they really think learning is, to inform practice and target key intervention. So our first study I would like to present you was conducted on pre-service teachers. And the sample was composed by 224 pre-service teachers. The sample has a gender imbalance because they were primarily female, but this reflects the real situation of our teacher sample. And we assessed their learning conceptions by using the questionnaire that you find in the slide, the reference developed by Chris Taylor. To identify the different profiles of conceptions of learning, we conducted cluster analysis, and we also performed ANOVA to investigate any significant difference between factors belonging to each construct. What did we find? We found three profiles solution. In the first profile that we called adaptive view on learning, we have the measure part of pre-service teachers. And they, those teachers think at learning as an opportunity for success and personal growth, and they feel highly engaged in the learning process, and they perceive self-confidence and self-determination, and have a future time perspective. So they provide us a picture of their involvement in the learning process and their ability to control the process, because they of course declare to experience negative emotions such as anxiety, of course, but this negative side of emotion is at low levels. Furthermore, we have a second profile that we call anxiety and lack of self-determination, and about 13% of pre-service teachers were in this second profile. It is characterized by a conception of learning really saturated with negative emotions, and in particular anxiety. And this is linked to the scarce low perception of controllability, that is also linked to external loss of control of their own success and failures, and also those of their students. Finally, we have the profile we call metacognitive approach that collected a quite significant part of pre-service teacher. Their conception of learning show a collective vision, a social vision of learning and learning practice, but in this social vision emerge a lot of feelings of anxiety and negative emotion emerge. So this is accompanied by low self-engagement and low self-determination and self-confidence. So thinking about this third profile that take together different kind of positive and negative aspects of conception, we reflect about the marginal and disengaged position in the community, maybe related to this part of present teacher population. Of course, we need further investigation on this point. Moving on to consider secondary school students' profiles. Indeed, this study I would like to present you. We have a sample composed by about 200 participants, and in this case we use a different but a very related to the previous questionnaire to assess the students' conception and the learning orientations. And also in this case we conducted cluster profile analysis, and in this case we found a two cluster profile solution. So we have on the one hand those students we call ATM, so those students that feel a controllability of their learning process, they feel engaged in the learning practice, and they have high level of self-regulation processes. They have a vision of the class as a community, and they have a high feeling of sense of belonging to their community. And this may help and support those students to refer to a teacher, of course, but also to the fellows, and maybe this could be an important point for requesting help at the city. And this profile, is positively linked and associated with school achievement. This profile predicts significantly high and excellent school performances. On the opposite side, we found a different profile we called dragged by different students, because the feeling was that those students have a scarce controllability and sense of responsibility in the learning process. So they feel they show low level of participation with respect to students in the other profile. They use surface learning strategies, and they lack of a strategic study approach. They feel high negative emotion, and they recognize the important guiding role of teachers, but at the same time they feel quite passive, in a quite receptive role. And when we try to look at the longitudinal pathways or longitudinal relations between secondary school students and later university outcomes, a is that those who at the end of the university program were identified as dropout or on-time students, those that completed on time the university program, retrospectively, so at the time of secondary school, had a higher level of on this conception of learning, that is learning as a reduction of basic knowledge and passive receptive. So this particular aspect of learning orientation from this from our result seems to play a key role in determining the longitudinal university pathways, of course also in this case within further examination. But it is quite an interesting result. So some discussion about the implication of those results with respect to students and teachers. So we think it is important to promote awareness about our own learning orientation, and this could be to transform our implicit conception, as I said before, to an explicit dimension that allow us to work on the strengths and weaknesses points of our learning orientations. And to promote awareness in students about the link between their learning orientations and their learning strategies and approach to study, to promote, of course, self-regulation, but also to take a primary role in their learning actions, agency in students. And this work could also conducted on present teachers and teachers to promote awareness about their personal learning orientations and the influence in their teaching practices and indirectly on students' learning orientation. And it could be also useful to support the teachers in decreasing their feelings of uncontrollability, to use the negative emotions as an informative data to better contain their negative feelings and to not be overwhelmed by negative emotions. So of course we would like to conduct next studies on research topics, and we also would like to investigate the relation between learning orientation and other kind of school outcomes, and of course the performance assessment of university could be an important perspective. And we also would like to capture more diversity in learning orientation, working on assessing students' background and contextual information, as other studies remind us in the course of this seminar. So thank you very much for your listening.